A volcanic bomb. So that's what brought my helicopter down.
Hi, I'm Susan Arendt, and this is the video supplement for my review of Return to Mysterious Island 2. Return to Mysterious Island 2 is, as you might have guessed, the sequel to Return to Mysterious Island, which was based on the Jules Verne novel, The Mysterious Island. Lots of mysteries, lots of islands. Your goal in the first game was to find a way off the island, and the sequel picks up right where the original leaves off, with Mina and her monkey pal Jep flying back to civilization in a helicopter, which is unfortunately shot down mere moments after taking off. Looks like you're going to have to find a way off the island again. And did I mention the volcano is about to explode? Yeah. Mysterious Island 2 is a classic adventure game, meaning you'll spend your time exploring your surroundings, collecting items, and solving puzzles. You split your time in the game playing as both Mina and Jep the monkey. But before you ask, no, you don't fling poo at anybody. But you do other monkey things, like catching ants with a blade of grass, or reaching high locations by climbing trees. You also communicate with other monkeys by grooming them, asking for gifts, or playing a catchy tune on your ocarina. So why would you ever want to play as a boring old human when you can be a monkey? That's a good question. But as talented as Jep may be, he is still just a monkey. He can't read, and he can't combine items to solve puzzles. For that, you need Mina. What makes Mysterious Island 2 particularly satisfying is that it combines common sense puzzle solving with plenty of red herrings. Many of the obstacles you'll face can be overcome by considering how you deal with them in real life. If you're hungry, but have a pole, a hook, a bobber, and some string, it shouldn't take you long to realize that you can assemble a fishing pole. But many of the items you find have more than one function. The carnivorous ants you use to sew up Mina's cut also provide a tasty snack for Jep. So solving puzzles isn't just a matter of clicking on everything until something happens, you actually have to think about it. Everyone's a critic.